All right, in this video, we're going to explore different visual styles. So if we look here, I've already got my box drawn. It's on layer zero, which is just a white layer. Because my background is white, it is actually making it kind of a grayish color. What it would normally do is actually make it black, but I do have it set to conceptual. So we're going to walk through these different visual styles, but I did make some new layers in here. And if you notice, I've got one called blue that's blue, green is green, red is red. So I'm going to, let's set this back to just basic 2D wireframe. I'm going to make copies of this box just so we can see what different visual styles do here. We're going to set one of them to be on the blue layer. We'll set one of them to be green and one of them to be red. All right, so, and I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that. That was my 2D rectangle. Okay, so we've got four different boxes here on four different layers, four different colors. So what I'm going to do now is change my visual style. So we're going to walk through the different visual styles that you can have. Right now I'm on what's called 2D wireframe. And with 2D wireframe, as you can tell, it just looks like it's a completely see-through box. But it is one of those things, because we're working with a 3D box that's see-through, it's one of those optical illusions. Like, it's hard to tell which one's the front, which one's the back. As you stare at it more, you can make it come towards you or away from you. So it's definitely hard to work with objects that are in 2D wireframe when you're working with 3D objects. So we'll look at the visual styles, which again are on the home ribbon or on the view panel. And that's 2D wireframe. In the first video you saw, I did a conceptual layer state or visual style. And so what that does is it actually takes warm and cool shades of a color. And so we can see my gray box was on layer zero, so it actually should be a blue box or a black box, but it's gray. The blue, you can see it was a bright blue here, but it's kind of a blue and then a little bit of green here. The green color, you can see there's light green and dark green. The red is the most drastically different of them all. There's no red in that. That is just an orange and a purple. But so that's what it's doing. It's kind of nice and it's easy on the eyes. If you've ever worked with a program called SketchUp, AutoCAD kind of got this from the SketchUp program. SketchUp came out right, it was actually out a little bit before AutoCAD made a change where they introduced this conceptual style. Now we've also got an option called hidden, so that makes it look, we can definitely tell they're solid boxes. They could very well just be isometric, the way that we would normally draw an isometric box, because we are viewing it in an isometric view. So that's that option, hidden. Realistic. So what realistic does, now I can see bright, bold blue and red and green. I can see that that other box that was gray earlier is just a solid black here. That's realistic. And then we've got one called shaded. So shaded doesn't look any different from realistic. The difference between those two is when you get more advanced and you start applying materials to these objects, like, for example, if I were to put bricks, a brick pattern on one, or a wood pattern on one, or glass, or, you know, any other kind of material that I wanted to put it in, realistic would show it with that material, whereas shaded would just show the layer color, like we see now. We don't have any materials applied, so they look the same right now. Now watch the edges, because we've got this other option here, shaded with edges. So just fix your eyes on one of these objects, and then do you see how the edges pop now? So that's kind of nice. If you're working with that shaded, it's nice to turn on the edges, just so you have a nice crisp view of the edges. We've got shades of gray. I honestly don't know why anybody would choose this. There's no point in having colors or any of it if you make it all look gray. Not sure about that one. Sketchy, it's pretty cool. It makes it look like a sketch. And as you zoom in, notice that the sketch has overlap. It overhangs the edges, so it looks like a hand sketch. And let's see, wireframe. That's similar to the 2D wireframe. It's just, notice we've got the 3D UCS down here, the background is white, as opposed to the 2D wireframe, we're still in kind of that 2D mode where the black background is. Again, not super easy to work with it like this, but you'll find if you start doing really, really big projects, like let's say you're doing a whole entire neighborhood or like a really intricate, complex object in 3D, your computer will start to lag if you leave it on something that is solid or conceptual. Your computer will start to lag because every time you move or pan or zoom, it's having to refresh those solid objects. So if you're working on really, really big 3D projects, you do want to put yourself into a wireframe mode. That makes it a lot easier for AutoCAD. It doesn't have to sit there and process every object as 3D. Now we do have this option here for Xray. So what's cool about Xray, let's do a little move command here. I'm going to pick up this guy. Let's pick it up here. And I'm going to snap it to the midpoint down there. So Xray, you can see through these objects. And so I can see where the red is in relation to the green. I actually prefer, you do what you prefer here. There's no right or wrong view here, but I prefer to stay in conceptual. And then if you come over to the, I believe it's the visualize. Yep, there it is. Under visual styles, so visualize ribbon, visual styles, you can turn on X-ray mode. And that way it keeps that warm and cool shade, but it's doing the X-ray mode. So that's always an option for you as well if you prefer, if you like working with that X-ray mode where you can see through the objects. So I just wanted to take you on a little tour of the different visual styles, what they do. There is, like I said, there's no right or wrong way to do this. You do what you feel comfortable with. I tend to keep it on the conceptual visual style, but you find what works for you and go for it from there.